So whenever ChatGPT doesn't work, this is my first go-to, as it's also completely free. And as I said, it's always up. If you're anything like me, you've been using ChatGPT every single day for the past 2 weeks. But unfortunately, the tool got so popular, with reaching 1 million users in just 5 days, that the site keeps going down due to too much traffic. And sometimes when I want to use it for work, I get one of these or one of these. Unfortunately, this blocks us from using the product. So this video will show you two alternatives that are also free and do equally as good of a job. Almost. ChatGPT is king right now. All right, first up, I want to show you Jasper AI. While this one is not completely free, you can sign up and get 5 days for free. And to create your account, all it takes is an email and you have to link a credit card. Just don't forget to cancel the auto renewal if you don't want to use it for more than the 5 days. And in your dashboard, you can go to documents and then use the free form template where you can start from scratch. And with that, you get a lot of the functionality from ChatGPT, just with a different AI model chatting with you. Let's just say you write an email to my boss about me being sick and taking the week off. By pressing Command and J, we request an answer from the chatbot. Dear boss name, I'm writing you to inform that I have come down with a fever and I will be taking the week off for medical leave. Okay, that's really useful. Now to compare, let's give the same prompt to ChatGPT and see what it comes up with. And yes, I would say this one definitely goes to ChatGPT. The key difference is being that Jasper assumes your sickness and doesn't really deploy empathy here. ChatGPT goes ahead and apologizes and is also very aware that there's some workload that will be left out due to you not being at work, even including a solution. So in this example, ChatGPT gave you something that you could literally copy and paste and change your boss's name, while Jasper is more of a starting point for your email. Nevertheless, really useful, especially when ChatGPT is not available right now. But wait a minute, before we move on, I need to show you some other capabilities, because this thing can do a whole lot more than just write emails. If you go to these templates, it can do a lot of concrete things, which is absolutely amazing. Like you could pick a preset so it writes your photo post caption. Just describe what your post is about. You can define the tone of voice and say generate. Time to hit the streets of Rome and see what the city is really about. I like that. Let's see what ChatGPT gets us as opposed to Jasper here. Taking on Italy one adventure at a time. And honestly, the ChatGPT ones are so generic that I really prefer the Jasper ones here. In this case, Jasper wins, so I guess it really depends on your prompt. Okay, next up, I'm gonna show you another alternative to ChatGPT, and this one is actually the best one. But before we get into it, if you're getting value from this content, leave a like and subscribe to the channel. It really helps out. And now let me show you OpenAI's playground based on the GPT free model. So I have to make a clarification here. ChatGPT and Playground are by the same company, OpenAI, but they're not the same. Both came out less than a month ago, but Playground is based on a DaVinci 00 free model, GPT free. And ChatGPT is based on GPT 3.5, so it's slightly more advanced. But the good thing about Playground is it's always up, so whenever ChatGPT doesn't work, this is my first go-to. So let's compare. Let's try the Instagram caption here and say submit. And as you can see in this concrete example, very, very similar results. But yet again, with the Instagram captions, I would say Jasper wins. But to round things out, let's look at that email to the boss example, because I feel like writing emails is one of the biggest everyday use cases this provides. Okay, and as you can see right here, these are just different shades of good. Speaking from personal experience, I would say ChatGPT and Playground are really good if you give it a minimal amount of information, like a one-liner without much context. It does an incredible job in assuming context, deploying empathy, and actually being creative while doing it. And Jasper is a fantastic alternative if you're more specific. If you use some of these concrete templates and give it more information, it will also do a great job in delivering content to you. Either way, now we have three tools to improve your everyday life instead of just one. And that's a win in my books. And if you enjoyed this content, chances are that you're using this tech for your professional life on a daily basis. And in that case, my video that specializes on ChatGPT prompts for content creators is exactly what you need, because it shows you some ways to use this tech that you might have not thought of.